Next is, there is a problem. A manufacturer produces bolts of fabric with fixed width. The quantity Q that is sold is function of P in dollars per yard. Thus, Q is equal to F of P. Now we are discussing the applications of these derivatives in real life, in business, in physics, in biology. So in every field we will have one problem. This is a kind of business problem. So the statement is, I'm not going to write the statement, I will share the PDF, you can read later. The question is, a manufacturer produces bolts of fabric with fixed width. The quantity Q that is sold is a function of P. You can see P is a variable, that is, and Q is the function. Total revenue R, and of course R will also depend on the price. It is P into the function Q, PQ, that is P F of P. What does it mean to say, first question is, he's asking, if I say F of 20 is 10,000, what does this mean? Can you tell me what does this mean? Can you tell me what does this mean?
No, I'm not sure.
Look, F of P equals to Q, and I said Q is the quantity of the production, and the quantity of the production is F of P, and this quantity is depending on the price. If the price of the product is higher, the quantity will be less. If the price is less, the quantity will be higher, or it will depend on any factors. Here he said, this equation, this is given in the statement, and the first part is, what does this thing means? This thing simply means, what is F of 20? It is actually Q. According to this equation, he simply used the price as 20. He said that one unit price of the production is 20. And if we set the price of the production 20, then we can produce 10,000 units. We can produce 10,000 quantity. So this is simply this equation, that if the price of the each unit is 20, then total quantity can be produced 10,000. So it actually gives the amount of the production. Second part is, also, what does this mean? F dash of 20 is minus 350. This is the second question. So what does this mean? Now, what is this?
It's even difficult.
Is it difficult? This you understand?
Yeah. That was easy.
Yeah, so now there is a derivative. Now there is a dash. Actually, the function was f, but in the second part, he is now talking about the dash, about the slope, about the derivative. So if something is going like this, step by step, okay? And here, suppose up till here, there is certain, you can say, quantity of the production. But he is asking that what is the change in the production at the 20th step? If at the 20th price, for example, if setting the price of the unit 19 gives you a certain amount, then what will be the change when you increase the price one unit from 19 to 20? So similar is the case if I am going down step by step. Now what is this? This is the slope. And I am standing here and I am saying, suppose this is 19, and one step more and I will jump to 20. So he says, what kind of difference is coming in total production when you increase just one unit price from 19 to 20. Similarly, if this is 10, then actually we are talking that what will be the difference if we go from 9 to 10. So this is giving me one actual, the change in the whole production according to one unit. So if I will step from here to here, this is one unit. He's asking me what kind of change is in quantity is appearing for a change in price for one unit, because F dash means change. When the thing was simple, it is simply the function. It is simply the production. But when you apply a derivative on it, now it become a change. Now you are talking about the change. This we were talking about the total production. This we are talking about the change in production by changing the price up to, suppose it is, if it is in dollars, then if you increase the price of one item, $1, then what will be the effect of this price hike on the production? So the answer says that your production will decrease minus 350. If you increase one unit, $1 price of the quantity, then your production will decrease minus 350. Means if you are at 20 and you increase the price to 21, your production, which was actually 10,000, then at the price 21, it will become 10,000 minus 350. So the production will decrease because you are changing the price one unit. You are increasing the price one unit, and the demand will reduce. People will not try to buy it because it is very costly. Although it is $1, but it depends on the demand. So the demand reduces. If the demand reduces, definitely you have to produce less. You cannot produce more if the things are not selling. So when there is a derivative, it is a discussion about the change. When there is no derivative, it is discussion about the total quantity. These are two different things. Do you understand?
Yes, yeah.
So this is the use of derivative in business. If you want to know that if you change one step, if you change one unit, then what will be the consequence of that one unit, then you will use the derivative. If you simply want to know that at this price, how much production I can make, you simply use the function. There is no involvement of derivative. But if you want to know the consequence of increasing the price, one unit, two unit, three unit, then you will use the derivative to see the change, expected change. Before doing this, before increasing the price, you want to get an idea that what can happen if I increase the price, what will happen? Then mathematically, theoretically on paper, you can get the picture that what will be the consequence. Of course, the actual result may be a little bit different, because mathematics is always giving you an approximation. It is giving you an idea that what can be the consequences. Of course, the actual situation may be this goes wrong. Maybe there are some other factors. There is a factor that if you increase the price one unit, but increasing the price one unit, it also increases the quality of the product. Like you can see, if you go to the market, some same kind of products, but there are two types of them available. One is cheaper and the other is at the higher rate. But the difference is the one at the cheaper rate has low quality. The one at the higher rate has high quality. Now there is not only one variable which is changing the production. No, there are two variables. One variable is the price and the other variable is quality. So in case of two variables, you will not only be focusing on the price, but actually you have to deal with the two variables, and you will say, okay, my function is now actually depending on the price, so, and also the quality.
Both.
No, function is single, but this function is now depending on two things. In that case, now you will use the partial derivative to calculate the change, right, which is the later stage. And I told you yesterday that we are not going into the two variables because that is a kind of advanced mathematics. So that's what I'm saying, that in reality the things may be different, because when you were calculating this, you didn't consider all the other factors which are also possible. You only consider the price. And of course, if the only price is the factor, then of course the production, and if you are increasing the price but the quality is same, no other variable is involved, no other alteration in the product is appearing, there is no change in the product is same, but what you did, you simply increase the price, then of course the production will decrease because people don't want to get the same thing at the higher price. So the production will decrease, but at one side, if you are increasing the price but also you are improving the quality, then this may be a positive sign. The production may also increase. So the things always depend on the variables. So you have to consider all the possible variables. But here, in one dimension, we are only considering the height, the price as a single variable. That is why the single variable price, when we apply the derivative, the answer will be in negative, means your production will decrease.
So in real life, we can have as many variables and according to the factors affecting.
When you are trying to analyze that what are the consequences of the change in your price, then you will have to consider all the variables which are involved in your factory. You will have to consider the labor, you will have to consider the quality, you will have to consider the population which is assumed to use your product. For example, if there is a city and there is total population say 10,000 and you are producing a quantity 20,000, then of course it will give you a loss, because the population was less and your product is more. And if the product is valid only for 10 days, the 10,000, okay, all of them use your product, then they can only use 10,000. The rest of the 10,000 will be lost. So this was another factor. The population is also a factor. Quality is a factor. The material used, the cost of the material is a factor. All these factors. But here in mathematics, when we...
So we will put those in variables.
Yeah. You have to consider all the variables. But in mathematics, we want to see the change according to one variable, then we assume that okay, there the other variables are constant, there is no change in other variables, and we keep them constant and fix one variable, and we see okay, this variable is changing, others are constant. When something is constant, the derivative has no effect on it, you can take it out. The same question, this question, and he says that, this is the revenue function. This is the revenue which you will get by using this function to produce a certain quantity, and you are producing that quantity using this function, then what will be your revenue? So this is the revenue function. And he says that if the price P is 20 and the f dash of 20, which were given here, is also the same, minus 350, and the total production f of 20 is 10,000, this is the data which was given to us in part A, when we were talking about the part A. He's saying, use the same data, and also the price is 20, use this data to tell us that what will be the change in revenue Question is, now the B part, what is the change in revenue in R of P? So I know the function R of P, but for finding the change in R of P, what should I need to do? This is a revenue function. If I apply these values into this function, these values will give me the revenue of the product. But he is asking, give us the change in revenue. What should I do with this equation?
You take derivative.
Derivative. So I need to take first the derivative, R dash of P. If I take the derivative, it is the product rule. It will become, is it the product rule? Yeah, P is also, P is variable, so it will become product rule. Both are these are the variables. So if you apply the product rule, it will become P F dash of P plus F of P into the derivative of this becomes 1. So now this is the equation to know the change in revenue if you increase the price from 20 to 21, or if you increase the, if you want to increase or change the price for 1 unit, for $1. So now simply plug in the values, that is R dash of 20, P is 20, F dash of P, F dash of 20 is minus 350, plus F of P, F of 20 is already given to you, 10,000. So whenever you calculate this, the final answer is 3,000. So it means that if you have these circumstances, that the change in product, the change in production is minus 350, actual production was 10,000, the price is 20, and you want to know that if we change $1 in the price, then what will be the effect on the revenue? He says the effect on the revenue will be 3,000, means still your revenue will increase 3,000 for changing the price 1 unit. This is an equation to calculate the reaction of a certain medicine. If the medicine, for example, if the medicine is injected into the body of a person and the medicine is flowing into the blood of a person, then what could be the reaction of that medicine? This equation is used to calculate that reaction on the body of a person. In this equation, R means the reaction of that medicine, M means the quantity of the medicine, I guess. Yes. And C is a constant, which was used to derive this whole equation. So what is the variable? What is the variable in this equation?
M?
Yeah. R is your function, and the function R is depending on the quantity of the medicine. If you give, for example, a simple medicine, if you take 500 milligram, sometimes it's okay. But if you take two medicines of 500 milligram, the reaction will increase. So what's happening? The quantity, when you increase, the reaction increase. If you take, instead of 500, if you take 250 milligram, then the reaction of the medicine will be less than the normal range, if it is supposed to be taken 500. So whole thing is, the reaction is depending on the quantity of the medicine which is to be injected in the body, and it is flowing in the blood of the patient. Now if okay, description of this equation, where C is a positive constant, M is amount of the medicine in the blood, R is reaction measured in millimeter of mercury, if you are talking about the blood pressure, and if you are talking about the change in temperature of the body, R is measured in degrees on the Celsius scale. Find dR by dm, which is sensitivity rate of the body to the medicine. The derivative of this equation dr by dm, this is called the sensitivity rate of the body in which you are trying to inject the medicine. So if you want to know that what is the sensitivity rate of a body according to a medicine, then you have to plug in the values and find the derivative of this whole equation. This equation is used in biology to calculate the sensitivity rate. This C is a constant which is used from the properties of the mathematics to calculate this whole equation. So this C will be given to you in a lab wherever you will go. If you want to calculate the sensitivity rate of a body, they will give you that, okay, this is the medicine, and for this medicine the value of C is this and the quantity is this, let's suppose 500 milligram, and they will also mention, or if you pick up that medicine, you can see the instruction on it on the bottle, you will see the values, they already mentioned it. So you don't need to calculate them, because of course a doctor also see these things in the other perspective. So it does not mean that if you know this equation and you can become a doctor. We have a, for example, if we have a cylinder filled of any kind of gas, and I'm saying that the temperature of the cylinder is constant, but of course the volume can increase, decrease, because when you fill the cylinder, you are actually changing the volume of the gas inside the cylinder. But we are assuming, of course the temperature will change a little bit, but we are assuming that there is no change in temperature. For my convenience, I am saying that this T is constant. I am simply changing the volume. Now, if I am changing the volume, I am injecting the gas into the cylinder, and I want to know the change in pressure per unit injection of the gas into the cylinder. Then, what should I do?
We'll take the derivative.
Take the derivative according to?
The volume.
Volume. So we will take the derivative as dp divided by dv. If I say that something has a constant volume, let's say a cylinder is placed on sunshine in a daytime, I'm not changing the volume of the gas inside the cylinder, but of course the temperature is changing because the sunshine is heating up the cylinder. So in that case, the variable is T, the volume is constant. In that case, if you want to know the change in pressure in the cylinder, then it will become dp by
dp over dt.
dt. So it is only always a game of the variable which is actual culprit. The variable is
okay.
Variable is important because he is the guy who is changing the whole scenario. You always have in this equation, and there is also a possibility that I can say both the temperature and volume are constant, but the molar mass is changing, the number of the molecules are changing, whatever the method is changing, but let's suppose,
okay,
then the derivative will change according to n, so it will become dp by dn. This why is very important, this is the culprit.
Okay.